Hi guys, Radhika here again. So today my video is on the topic of a narcissistic boss. So I know a lot of people, they face narcissism in the workplace because really the corporate culture is kind of one that breeds narcissists. Basically any kind of hierarchy in society, wherever it is, even the government or offices like software offices or any industry, police office or even the university, educational offices, all of these workplaces where there is a certain hierarchy, they are going to breed narcissists. They are going to give an opportunity for the inner narcissist to come out. Because this is kind of like a ladder climbing kind of a place. So you basically climb the ladder and you step on some people and then you move up the ladder. So it's that kind of an environment. A lot of times people who have narcissistic personality disorder, they will actually rise to the very top of a company or of like a particular police organization or of army, military, etc. Now I'm not saying everyone who is on the top is a narcissist, but it's a great opportunity for someone to gain power. And with power, a narcissist feels like his narcissistic supply has been met. You know, they can command people, they can order people around, they can get to feel superior because they have like so many people working for them, etc. So I have seen this a lot, and it's an ego booster for the narcissist. So narcissism is basically ego on a super high degree. So it's like an animal instinct, ego, and it has come in a human body, you know. So the body is actually of a human, and we attribute all these qualities of empathy and niceness, and we also think of humans as egoistic, but we are trying to move to the better emotions, right? But a narcissist will stay stuck in the baser emotions, in the animalistic, more egoistic kind of emotions. So I wanted to give you some signs of a narcissistic boss, because if you don't know about narcissism, it sometimes becomes very difficult. Because if you are an empath and if you yourself do not have a very big ego, if you are the kind who self-doubts or who takes other people's word very seriously, if you have some characteristics of being a people pleaser, or you want everyone to feel good around you all the time, it might be indicative that you yourself don't have a very good ego. So your ego is not completely built up yet. So to feel good, usually like people who are well balanced, they have their ego. So they know their boundaries, they know who they are, and they know who other people are. So they will be good to good people, and they will stop wasting their energy when they see that this person in front of them is just basically just wasting their energy or sucking out their energy. But if you do not have a proper idea of this, what can happen is that a narcissist will often pretend to be a good person, like a covert narcissist. And narcissists can also be intellectual narcissists, so they will be very intellectual. So you might actually be really impressed by them as a personality, and they also show that they are very good people. So there's a very great chance that you might get fooled by such a personality. And in such cases, what happens is a lot of water is under the bridge, and you have wasted a lot of your time and a lot of your energy on this one person, And then you start coming to the realization that why are all these things happening with me? So this can happen also in an office environment. I have seen this happen where there's a narcissistic boss, there's a really talented employee, but the employee might not fit into the boss's image. So the boss, the narcissistic boss, might have like a template that they want to fit an employee into, and this employee might be something out of the template, but at the same time the employee might be a really good employee. So I have seen such cases happen where narcissistic bosses take advantage of employees who are people pleasers, who are empaths, who don't voice their opinion too much, who kind of go with the flow and try to make everything work. So these kind of employees, first of all, they give in a lot of their energy towards their work, and the bosses, not only do they not support them, but they also make them feel like these employees lack confidence. Now, I have seen this happen to a lot of friends of mine who are really good, confident people, but are inherently quiet. And the bosses want these employees not to be so quiet. So what they will do is they will attack the confidence of such a person. They will say, maybe you lack in confidence, maybe your communication skills are bad. And it's just because everyone else is too aggressive and this particular person is not as aggressive as everyone else. So the corporate culture in a way breeds narcissism, it breeds aggression, it breeds pushing your agenda. So it breeds all these things. And people who are not narcissistic, they just keep on doing their work. They try to improve the project or the product that they're working on, but not necessarily by trying to convince everyone that they are doing the right thing. They just do the work. They don't look for recognition. But the problem is such people are hardly ever recognized. And usually a narcissistic boss will lead to their downfall. So such an employee might lose confidence. They might try to change teams. They might try to quit their job. They might even try to change the role that they are in, thinking that they are not good enough for this particular role. So I just wanted to share some signs of these narcissistic bosses, and just keep in mind, no one is going to tell you right away on your face that you are doing a really bad job and you should quit and this and that, and no one's going to try to tell you on your face that, hey, I'm secretly trying to bring down your confidence, but they are doing it. So that's why I want to make this video, because you have to be aware of such things. So first of all, as in any situation with a narcissist, always trust your instincts. If you don't feel good with a person, you don't feel good with that person. So don't think that, oh, something is wrong with me, maybe I'm not too adjusting or I'm not too adaptive and everyone has to adapt. No, don't think that. Just know that this person is probably not good. That's why you're not feeling good around that person. So here are some things that a narcissistic boss might do. They may praise other employees in front of you, especially in one-on-ones. Now, they won't do this in a competitive way. The way they will do this is that this employee is doing so and so, and that's really great for their career, etc. So what they're trying to do is they're trying to subtly influence you and subtly make you compete with that particular employee. Also subtly tell you that you are not as good as they are, because just look at this logically. This is a one-on-one. Okay, so you are supposed to discuss what are your problems with your boss. Your boss is not supposed to talk about other people with you in your one-on-one. So the discussion should only be focused on you and the person and your boss. No one else should be included in this conversation, other than if it's something that you bring up, that you have a conflict with so and so. So a lot of bosses do this. What they try to do is they try to pit people against each other, and that's how they make the team competitive, and they feel that everyone is going to do well if they make this competition going between people. So be aware of this. Another thing related to this is that your boss might have favorites. So it's going to be pretty obvious. They're going to praise this person again and again. And this person might actually be doing a good job. So it's not like they are praising someone who's not doing a good job. It's just that they might be praising a person who is overworking or who is delivering more than promised. And what they want to do is by again and again praising such a person, they're making them the golden child, basically, in a narcissistic clan. And a lot of narcissistic bosses might not go to the point of scapegoating, but they might do covert scapegoating, because they don't want to lose employees really. But what they want is they just have that instinct, right? They have to create competition, so they will scapegoat someone, but it will be in a very covert way, or in jokes and things like that. They might make jokes of you, or they might talk a little bit about you, that you know, so and so is not good enough to other people. So it won't be as bad as it is in a narcissistic family, but it can be bad, as in it can affect you very badly. But gossip wise, I don't think in a office culture you can do as much you can't ruin someone's reputation as much as you can do in a family narcissistic environment. Okay, then in one-on-one sessions, they might always first bring up something that you did not deliver on, that you did not accomplish completely, that you missed out on. So they might discuss these things more than discussing your accomplishments. Your accomplishments, whatever they are, you will always be made to feel that these are small. So no matter how big they are, they will make it feel small. And again, to the favorite person that they have, no matter how small the favorite person's accomplishments are, the boss will make them look really big. Like, even if they send out an email, it will be like, oh, what a great email that person sent out. And you might have done a whole project, but you're not going to get any praise for that. So this is another thing. Then another thing a narcissistic boss loves doing is, first they will praise you a lot. They will say you are ready for the next level, and they will show you this, they will dangle this carrot of promotion in front of you, and they will say you are ready for the next level, you need to get there, and these are the things that we need to do to get there. So they kind of form like a psychosis with you, like we have a joint interest, you know, like I'm helping you with this. And what they are doing is basically they're making you work. And in the end, when the time comes for your appraisal, for your review, they're going to say, oh, you fall short in this and this. And all the year round, you might have worked like all the time, completely, your entire schedule must have been just office work. But no, the narcissistic boss is going to find something or the other that has been missing, because that's been their plan all along, right? Subtly, at some subconscious level, they know that we are just going to make this person work, and so person is not going to get promoted, and they are going to promote whoever they like more, or probably not anyone. So basically, this is a very common thing that narcissistic bosses do. They will try to show you that they are working for you, they are working with you towards a promotion or towards something, and in the end they will just back off. They will put the entire blame on you. They will say, oh, you failed at communicating so and so. They will always bring out all the bad things that happened during the project cycle, during the 1 year cycle. They will bring it out. They will forget all your accomplishments. So with a narcissistic boss, it's really difficult, because if you want to get promoted, you have to do everything that they ask you to do. Even if you miss one checkbox, it's gone. So they will point out that particular checkbox. And basically what you do is you're just writing your life away for this narcissistic boss, because even if you check all the checkboxes, you get promoted, you have to keep on doing this for the rest of your time in that company. So is that worth it? Do you want to do it for a promotion, for a title, for like an increase in the salary? Do you want to like write your life away for this person? So that's your choice, but that's what a narcissistic boss wants you to do. So I have an example of this, of my ex-boss, and she was a female, and she was the same way. She would, she was actually after me that in this year you have to get promoted. And I was doing very good in office, and she was actually encouraging me. So in the beginning I would feel like, oh, what a great mentor I have, and she's encouraging me and trying so that I can get promoted. And the way she would promote me, like the way she would inspire me, was in our one-on-ones that we had, she used to tell me that I wasn't married at the time, I didn't have a baby. So she would tell me, oh, you are a free bird, you have all of the weekends for you, and this is the time to work in life. You will get married and you will have babies and you won't have time to work then, and you can utilize your weekend. So see, she did not ask me to work, she would say you can utilize the weekends. So she was kind of like trying to subtly tell me to work on the weekends, but not really. So and then she would tell me things like, you are the only one who's stopping your progress. And if I did something, like say she would tell me that, ask so and so person for help regarding this thing, and if I wanted to figure it out on my own in my own time, say I want to take 2 days instead of 1 day to figure out a thing, she would tell me, she would kind of like scrutinize me on the time that I take to do a particular thing. So she would tell me, you took 2 days to do that thing, whereas I told you, you should have asked so and so and you could have gotten it done in 1 day. And that was just not my attitude, really. I did not, it's not that I was not communicative, but I wanted to see the code myself. I wanted to read it myself, I wanted to understand it myself, instead of just going to someone and asking for a solution. So a different boss might think that this is the right approach to take, but my particular boss, she was only concerned with results, she was not concerned with the process of learning. So she did not actually fit my style of work, which is more like exploratory, learning, creative. She was just like, ask so and so and do it, ask so and so and do it, like robotic, you know. She wanted you to be a robot and she wanted you to do everything that she says. And I did not actually know about narcissism then, but she kind of wanted to control so many aspects of my life. She would ask me, okay, with whom do you have your lunch? And if I had lunch with my roommate, she would tell me that, why don't you meet more people? And she would tell me things like, basically she would tell me that, why do you eat with your roommate? You can talk to your roommate when you go back home, but why don't you kind of network and meet more people? Now someone might feel that this is not a bad thing to say, and that's what I felt back then. So I did understand what she was telling me logically. So I get it that we need to network and make new friends, but I just don't think it was her place as a boss to tell me that in a one-on-one. And that too, it's just, she is stepping outside the boundary of being a corporate boss. So it's actually an HR issue. If someone is telling me whom I should have lunch with, she has some control freak issues in her, and she's trying to control a lot of aspects of her employee's life. So and the other people in my team felt that too. She would like really get into people's personal lives and ask them their schedules, and then check up on their schedules that, hey, have you dropped off your wife to college that you were going to do that today? And my teammate would be like freaked out that, oh my god, like why is she keeping like a watch on me, like she's FBI or someone. So these are the signs of narcissistic bosses, And they are really funny if you take it in the funny way. If you see the movie Horrible Bosses, it's really funny. It's just that a lot of employees actually love their work and they are very passionate about it. So was I. I was very passionate about the job that I had with the narcissistic boss, and I'm passionate about my current job too. But I have a good boss now, thankfully, touch wood. But what I'm saying is that a lot of people lose a lot of confidence because of such narcissistic bosses. And they will make it a point to make you as aggressive in the office environment as they are. If you are not as aggressive as they are, they see it as a weakness. So those are some of the signs of a narcissistic boss. So if you have a narcissistic boss, please do write in the comments. Please do like, subscribe and share these videos. And let's bring some awareness about narcissism, about narcissistic personality disorder, so that we can stop these negative vibes from going around in the world and we can transmute them into positive things. So thanks for watching my video. I hope you guys have a lot of love and a lot of light in your life. Thank you. Bye.